I'll take it. What's going on, guys? Thank you. Thank you.
There's a weight limit on that.
Hey, Mr. Bader. Congratulations on that victory. Great win, obviously, beating a legend like Fedor. Scott Coker came in here earlier, and he was talking about how you're definitely one of those guys up there at the top, pound for pound. And here you are, standing with three Bellator belts, first person to ever win two, let alone three. What do you think of your own legacy at the top of the Bellator fighters list? Do you think you're going to go down as one of the greatest of all time in Bellator and MMA in general?
Yeah, I'm not even thinking about that. I think this kind of solidifies that I am one of the best pound for pound out there, you know, but... it's just one of those things where I feel like I'm in my prime right now, so there's a lot more to go, and so I haven't even really begun to kind of scratch the surface on legacy and all that kind of stuff. So, but this is—I mean, this was a pinnacle right here. It's heavyweight championship. I'm the light heavyweight champion. I got to fight Fedor, one of the best of all time, you know, in the Grand Prix style tournament, and become a two-division champion. I mean, what else is there to do? You know, I can't drop to 185. You know, you can defend him and all that, but. To do that against that competitor, you know, in Fedor, and as you look back on a career, I mean, that'll always be a highlight.
Right over here. As you're sitting there in the cage waiting for him to make his entrance, you know, he's slow, he's taking his time, this big Russian, everyone's going nuts for him.
Yeah.
What are you thinking as you're sitting there waiting for him to get in there?
I'm just trying to focus on what I put myself there before in training camp and all that, you know, because, you know, all the hoopla and the, you know, fighting Fedor and, you know, trying not to get the wide eyes and looking across from a legend and all that. And it's experience. I've done that in my past. I've fought, you know, legends of the sport, who's who of MMA. So for me, I try to put that way down deep and not even think about it. It pops up every once in a while in training camp and fight week and all that, but... when I'm standing across there, I've never done the, you know, the with the flags coming out and all that, Star Spangled Banner. It definitely was different for me, but it got me fired up. And it's kind of like you walk out, you have those emotions going, and then it slows down a little bit, and so then you kind of got to, you know, kick it back up a little gear. But man, it was fun.
Then that left hits, and you see him go back. Do you have a human moment there, or are you still?
You know what? I saw that moment, and you can ask my team. You know, we practiced that moment a lot, and I saw that punch was going to do it. You know, he throws. You can't see his right hand because he throws from his hip. You know, it's very hard to see. He throws hard. But in doing so, you leave yourself exposed. And we felt that he was going to respect my wrestling a lot, and I could put one up top. And if you look through any of the footage on you know, the ones that didn't get played, but on the countdown shows and all that kind of stuff, we were practicing that punch the whole time. Throwing a jab, you know, getting our distance, and then feinting and throwing that left hook, and we knew he'd be there. And it just, you know, that's a hard punch right there. You know, he went down, and I saw that over and over again already, so it just kind of played out how we saw it.
Ryan, to your left, congratulations on the win. Beating Fedor, what, now that you've done it, what is that like? You know, you were in the ring with Tito Ortiz and John Jones,
yeah,
and a lot of great fighters, and you referenced that before.
Yeah.
Did this guy mean anything more because you watched him before, or because of his mystique?
Yeah, like I was telling him, I kept that down inside. You know, this definitely, if I had the opportunity to fight any fighter, you know, if you asked me, you know, when I started fighting, it would be Fedor, you know, and you know, that aura and mystique about him, you know, and look what he's done in this tournament. You know, he goes out there and finishes two tough guys in the first round, you know, and you know, props to him. He comes out here, he does a heavyweight tournament with a bunch of killers and makes it to the finals, you know. So I'm very honored to be part of his story and now have him be part of my story. You know, what happened tonight, you take nothing away from Fedor. You know, he's put in that work, you know, and he's cemented his legacy, you know. So for me, I try to keep my head down, and, you know, it's time to cement mine.
You threw that left hook from a good distance away. Sometimes, you know, left hooks are, you know, like you think of Joe Frazier,
yeah,
on that inside like that. Did you think you had the power on it from that distance to be able to do what you did?
Oh, yeah. You know, in the back there, too. You know, it was kind of funny. My coach has a... little kind of hurt elbow, so you know, we weren't throwing hooks to, you know, holding a pad out here and throwing a hook. You know, he was holding a pad at his head, you know, and he was circling away, and holding it up here. So I was getting my distance the whole time on that. You know, in the back, that's, I mean, 50% of the punches thrown in the back there, warming up was that punch. You know, we were setting it up, distance and all that, and then and kind of circling him into that, feinting, kind of get his hands down, which they're already down. But then we're trying to get him more or less to run into that punch too.
And that, you know, as great a punch as that left hand was, you hit him with the right from, I mean, that really, do you think the right hand was a bigger punch than the left? Because, you know, it seemed like maybe he was starting to get up and you cracked him with that right and it was the end.
Maybe he's just too tough for his own good. You know, that punch was hard. The left hook was hard. And then I waited for a second, you know, because I didn't want to follow up. But the ref didn't stop, jump in to stop it, so I followed it up with that hard right hand. You know, and I have a pretty hard right hand from that short little distance. And so I cracked him with that one, and it was kind of like, all right, that's enough, you know.
And last question for you. Can you evaluate yourself, compare yourself, a light heavyweight to heavyweight? Do you think you're better at heavyweight because you don't have the weight cut and that you're able to, you know, kind of combine all your talents?
Yeah, I don't know. You know, I have to go back and, you know, I haven't cut weight the last couple fights. You know, it's been nice. It takes an added stress out. And yeah, I think coming in at your natural weight without sucking any water out, you know, sucking 15, 20 pounds of water out of my body and trying to put it back on, it's got to do something to you, you know. But at the same time, it's also experience. Even though I have a lot of fights, it's still experience at the big stage and these main events. I get more comfortable every time I walk out of there. So I feel like I'm good at both, but, you know, it's definitely easier and a lot more fun fighting a heavyweight. Kind of what I was talking about over here, I saw that happening. I just didn't know when. I thought the longer the fight went, the more in favor it was for me, you know. And we planned on kind of getting into that firefight like you do with Chael at the first round, because even though it would suck, I feel like it would benefit me in the long run, you know. And I did feel like I was gonna connect on him with that punch, or, you know, a right hand, timing his right hand and throwing my own. I felt like I could go punch for punch with him and put him down. But no, you never think it's gonna go that quick. You know, that was twice in this tournament that's happened. You know, 15 seconds, I think this one was like 35 seconds. So always nice, you don't have to go five rounds, get a knockout, get the walk out of there, not break a sweat, you know. So it's always, and be healthy too. You know, the tournament's over, but like the first round with Kimo, when I got to get out of there healthy and just move on, it was nice.
And you've had a great stretch here with the tournament and obviously your last 12 fights as well. What's been the biggest difference with what you've been doing in this stretch compared to your previous?
Yeah, I mean, in my past, I've always had the physical abilities. You know, they were always there, but sometimes the mental side of it. You know, I was younger coming in as a wrestler, didn't know what the hell I was doing on my feet. I literally didn't know what I was doing on my feet until I was fighting Rashad, you know, and I got a jab. I was like, oh, it's so much nicer being able to not freak out, you know. And so the people around me, you know, the coaches and people I have around me right now, we're just in a good groove. We mesh really well, and it's fun for me. I made a promise after my last loss to go out there and have fun, not worry about, you know, the result of everything, and hype it up and whatnot. And ever since then, it's been a great run.
Hey, Ryan, over here. Last time
I don't have anybody on the schedule. I don't know a date, nothing.
Hey, Ryan, congrats. Ryan's friend. The left that you hit with Fader, is that the same one that you landed on Mo that knocked him out?
Yeah, more or less. This one I had to go out and kind of reach him a little bit, because Fader kind of has that stance where he's kind of straight up, kind of hopping, he's a little back. With Mo, he's always ducking his head to the side with his hands down. So we were setting up a little high kick or a left hook with him. But with Fedor, you know, Fedor waits and tries to time you, and I was trying to time him, because I knew he was timing me, you know, and he's trying to throw a right hand. And that's when I kind of, you know, he had to respect my wrestling. So I think him looking at my fight with Matt, he's like, he's going to come out here and just try to take me down right away, trying to get me tired, you know. So I wanted to use that to my advantage, give it a little feint, and let him run into that left hook. And, you know, if you look at kind of the picture, it's almost straightened out like that. So hit him hard, and we practiced that a lot.
Did you get punched one time in this tournament?
I don't think so.
That's unbelievable.
Yeah.
I mean, that,
you know, Matt might have – I don't remember getting punched on the feet. You know, it might be one of those things on the ground or something. But Yeah, I mean, you know, not in the first two fights at all. Then with Matt, I mean, if he got me on the bottom or whatever, but yeah, not. I mean, looking back, the fight before that, didn't get hit. You know, then we go to the Phil Davis fight, which is, I think there's like four punches total in it.
On Twitter, Tito Ortiz said that he wants to come back and fight Chael Sonnen and then fight you again. Would you have any interest in having that fight back, that rematch with Tito?
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah.
After I won the title, I was bugging him. He was at the bar. We were both there, and I was like, hey, you coming back? He's like, I'm done, man. I'm done. So, yeah, I mean, that'd be fun. You know, he has to come back and definitely prove himself. And obviously, that's, you know, a fight I don't dwell on, but fight that I want to get back. You know, all my losses, but it'd be a fun fight.
A few years ago, at Dan
Corn. I don't think he has anything left to prove, you know? I'm one of those guys, though, if your heart's in it and you want to, and it's you're not going to be satisfied in your life unless you do one more or you want to go out on a win, then, you know, he should be able to do what he wants. You know, he's earned that right. And but, yeah, I mean, I see both sides. You know, you want to remember him also as, you know, the Fedor Pride era, tearing people up, you know, and he's been able to. That's the thing, though, too. If you look at, yeah, he got Mitrione got him, but he went through and beat Mir and Sonnen in the first round. You know, it's not like he's lost five in a row or anything like that. You know, he's coming off a win streak here and in the finals of a heavyweight tournament. So, I mean, that's up to him.
We'll do one more over here.
Yep.
What do you do tonight to celebrate? Not only a win over Fedor, but you know, getting a heavyweight belt. What's the celebration?
It's always like sweeter before the fight. You're like, oh, I'm gonna do all this. I'm gonna do this. To be honest, I got a bunch of family and friends here. We'll go back to the hotel bar. I'll have a couple of beers and try to eat because I've been eating protein bars and that all day. I want to eat something different. Honestly, and then I'm gonna stay here. I got my kids here. At the beach, so I'll stay here a couple of days and then go home, really hang out with family. You know, it's a lot different now than, you know, having kids and all that kind of stuff. So, but the best feeling is you fall asleep at night, like tonight, right? And you wake up and you, every morning of this week, you're like, what day is it? Oh, I got weigh-ins today. Oh shit, it's fight day, you know? And tomorrow I get to wake up and open my eyes and say, man, I'm heavyweight champion and a light heavyweight champion and I just beat Fedor. So that's a good morning right there.
We'll end it on that. Thank you, guys. Thanks, Ryan.
Yeah.
Easiest guy in the division. Now you have more belts than DC has. Any message for Daniel Cormier?
You know, I'm over that, but you know, he's one of those guys. He proves himself over and over again. He's a champ. You know, in and out of the cage there, beating monsters. You know, nothing but respect from over here. You know, it'd be fun to do a cross promotion for the champ. But we'll see if that ever happens.
Brian, congrats on the fight.
Thank you.
You talked about your strategy offensively. About throwing the lead left hook, especially how Fedor keeps that right hand.
So our whole thing was going to go out there. We didn't want to go out there and take him down right away. I mean, if it presented itself and he got a result on the right hand, yeah, we would have done that. But I want to go out there, kind of establish it with kind of a jab. I want to kind of pod him a little bit and see what he was kind of read him, basically. And what I was reading out there was he was waiting for that time to throw his jumping right hand. And I could see it in his muscles. He gives a little twitch, he's ready. So I was staying just outside that distance and I kind of threw like a little left to see where I was at. And then I kind of stepped down or fainted and threw that left hook and caught him. You know, I mean, there's only 30 seconds, but that's what I was seeing. I was just trying to read him out there. And that was my whole goal. I was gonna stay out of that kind of that firefight, you know, being in there with him. At the beginning, but at the same time, make him work hard and kind of get his energy levels kind of down and then kind of take over. But I just happened to catch him with that left beforehand.
He's kind of known not just as a takedown artist, but someone who's actually reverses takedowns in the middle of a takedown. He's done that quite a lot. Did that alter your entry or your takedown game or your strategy going in?
Yeah, I mean, it was kind of weird with Chael. You know, Chael ducked him and he grabbed his arm. It was pretty impressive, and threw him and hipped him over. You know, hipped over. That was one of the things where that we were willing to go in there and be in bad positions for that first round, and you know, do all that spazzy stuff to get him tired. You know, even if he did wind up on top, he threw. You know, he's very strong in his hips and explosive. He'll kind of lay there, and if you try to advance on position, he'll explode. You know, and so we were willing to go through that to come out in the second round and be like, all right, I'm fresh. I feel good. I know I could go five rounds hard. I didn't know he's never been five rounds, over three, you know. So that was kind of the plan going in. But, you know, at the same time, I thought I could catch him too with his hands down.
And last question. A fan of MMA,